guys, and welcome back to my channel and today's video. So today I'm going to do a makeup tutorial using Kat Von D Saint and Sinner palette. But before we get into the video, I highly suggest you guys to subscribe and do so, because I upload videos every single day, so you get a lot of videos from me. I need to test the battery and zoom you guys in, so I'll see you in just a second. I'm just gonna put up my hair. Do you see that it is a little bit pink? I actually put in some red dye because my hair started to get blonde, like a semi-permanent dye that I mixed with conditioner. Not the smartest. But I don't mind because it's just hair and my hair looks like shit anyway, so I really don't mind. This palette is the Kat Von D Saint and Sinner palette, and it was limited edition, no longer available. I don't really know when it launched, but it came to Sweden in November last year, and for some reason I was asleep or something, so I didn't get my hands on this. And I was so bummed out. And then I have an amazing subscriber that reached out to me, and I will do my best not to cry because I already have. She contacted me and said that she had two of these. She had one for herself that she bought, but she got one in a birthday present. So she just had one laying around and asked me if I wanted it. And I was like, what? Like, okay, oh my god, I'm already tearing up. Oh my god. Oh. Like, honestly, this is so freaking crazy. Like, I have no idea what I have done to... Like, I don't feel like I say this enough, but you guys are amazing, you mean, to me. Not only because I got this, but I see you guys sharing on your Insta story that you are watching me and recommending me to your friends, and I'm like... It means... so much to me, and each and every one of you means so much to me. That's why I take so much time to answer everyone. That's why I take so much time for my YouTube, because this is my happy place. Not only because you are amazing and send me out amazing gifts, but I do really appreciate it. And this was sent to me by, I'm not gonna say her last name because I don't know if I'm allowed to, but this was sent by, and this is so hard because I tried to say this before in English, but Kirsten, but then it's Kirsten, and her name is Kerstin. We say Kerstin in Sweden. So Kirsten, Kerstin, whatever, thank you so much. I will do a bunch of tutorials with this. Let me know if you want three looks or just videos on it, because and if you haven't seen it, it looks like this. So this is the saint side and this is the sinner side. This is untouched. This is not even swatched. It's crazy. But the weird thing is that this brown really speaks to me, this pink, and then this lime. And with those three, I don't think I can do a look. Like, honestly, when I see this palette, I don't know what to do because I see so many opportunities. I'm like, oh! And I know a lot of people didn't like this jumbled eye or palette. I do. I don't mind a palette being jumbled. I love it because I can see so many opportunities. So I'm actually going to go in with this brown shade, this cool tone brown shade that is called Crucifix. And then I'm going to go in with a black probably, which is called Sabbath. And then I'm going to take this on my lid. And this packaging, honestly, I want to frame this. Okay, so this was a long intro. Let's just hop into the video now. So I'm starting off with the shade Crucifix, and I'm just going to apply this in my outer corner and then blend it up towards my crease. So I can't speak for everyone, but I can only speak for myself. And regarding the palette and how it looks and everything, I feel like some people are a bit sensitive towards jumbled up eyeshadows, like eyeshadow palettes. I don't know, but I like the fact that Kat did this, and I love the design that she did. The subculture palette is also jumbled up. The modern Renaissance is also jumbled up, but they are jumbled up in a different way, where there's no colorful shadows. Like, the modern Renaissance has some colorful shadows, but not a vibrant green, and, you know, I don't know, I like it. Okay, so now that we have this base on, I love the fact that she did a cool tone brown. I'm just gonna smoke this up towards my brow bone. I think I'm gonna leave it at that so I can go in with my black later on. It's been so long since I've done a grungy look. Lately I've been so intrigued about doing so colorful and springy looks, so I'm really happy about this, that I'm finally getting my grungy look. But I do have to say that I found this a bit tricky to blend, like it looks a little bit patchy and stuff, but I'm not gonna worry about that since I'm going in with more color, or a black I mean. Also, I did use a different eyeshadow primer today than I usually do. Going in with this right here, I think that the black shade will go beautifully together with this cool tone brown. That was super easy. Okay, so it's looking black and neat. So now that I'm thinking about it, like honestly, this shade looks stunning, but this shade as well. Like, I have so many shades I wanna play with. Oh, okay. This is the, she has one of these shades in her 10-year anniversary palette as well. Okay, I'm gonna go in with this shade. This is called Exodus. I don't know if this needs a white base or not, so I'm gonna just take a little bit on a brush and see how it applies. This is like a matte that contains shimmer, but I do feel like it's best under a white base, so I'm gonna take a bit of the NYX Milk Pen. This looks nice. I like it. So I'm gonna go in with a bit more of the black shade, just to melt everything together a bit. So I'm just gonna place it right here next to the green shade. So I did go ahead and apply the shade, let's see, Absolution, which is this shade, which is really stunning. It changes this color a bit, but I thought that it was really cute anyway. So I'm just going in with a flat brush, and this is a very, very glittery shade, so I get it all in my lashes, I got it on the black, but I don't really mind. Now I wanna take the shade Exorcism, which is this purple, and I'm gonna use this under my eyes. I'm just putting this right here, blending it in towards with the black. I'm stopping right here. So now what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna take this flat brush, and yes, I have swatches all over my arm. I'm taking this flat brush and just adding some purple in it. And then I'm going to do this. Oh my god, I look like a drag queen. Beautiful. Anyway, I'm gonna put this and create a line, which will make my eyes look a little bit bigger. A trick I learned from the one and only Nikki Tutorials. So now I'm gonna take another shade, and this is the shade Baptism. It's not white, it's like a baby, 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 baby pink, but it's not gonna appear like a pink. So I'm putting this in my inner corner, and I'm very, very gentle so I don't ruin anything. Maybe I should have taken a smaller brush, but. And then lastly, I'm just gonna apply some Absolution in my inner corner, which was this glitter shade, to tie everything together. It doesn't have to be much, it's just a little bit. Okay, I'm going to apply some lashes, probably some big lashes, I think, and then I'll be right back. Okay, so this is the finished look. I just put on some big dramatic lashes. These are from Scandal Lashes, as always. These are the Hollywood, no, these are the Forbidden Fling. And then I have ColourPop's liquid lipstick in the shade Femme. But I was just outside walking my dog because he needed to pee. And I decided that I'm gonna do three looks with this palette. I'm gonna do a three look one palette with this palette just because I feel like only doing some like talking tutorials on this will not give it justice. You see how many shades this is and how many things you can do. So I'm doing this for the people that has this palette or have similar shades like this that maybe are stuck in a rut or something that want to explore more with the palette and shop their stash of some sort. How many shades is there? There are 3, 6, 9, 18, 22, 24 shades in this palette, which is a lot of shades. So honestly, I feel like I want to use this more and I want to do it in a three looks one palette, but I will not review this palette because I feel like there's no point of me reviewing this since the palette is no longer available to purchase, but I will give you some thoughts on what I feel about this palette and how I like it and so on in the intro of the three looks one palette with this one, because I want to. I really, really want to do that with this. It's just so beautiful. I love it. Honestly, it's so beautiful. Thank you so much, Kirstine or Shashtin. Oh my God, I don't really know how to pronounce your name in the correct way, but in Sweden we say Shashtin, so thank you so much. And thank to everyone who has watched this video. Hope that you will like this tutorial. I know it's not for everyone, but I hope that you enjoyed it anyway. Don't forget to subscribe if you're not subscribed and like the video if you liked it, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye!